हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग सम कन्वेंशनल क्वेश्चंस ऑफ कंप्रेसर फ्लो। द टॉपिक इज एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज मेन 2013 इज एन एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर हैज एन ओवरऑल प्रेशर रेशियो ऑफ 4.0 एंड मास फ्लो ऑफ 160 किलोग्राम पर मिनट। इफ द पोलट्रोपिक एफिशिएंसी इज 0.88 एंड द स्टैग्नेशन प्रेशर राइज पर स्टेज मस्ट नॉट एक्सीड 25 डिग्री सेल्सियस, कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ स्टेजेस रिक्वायर्ड एंड द प्रेशर रेशियो ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड लास्ट स्टेज। Assume equal temperature rise in all stages. If absolute velocity approaching the last rotor is 155 meter per second at an angle of 20 degree from the axial direction, the work done factor is 0.83. The velocity diagram is symmetrical and the mean diameter of last stage rotor is 180 mm. Compute rotational speed and length of last stage. Ambient conditions are 1.01 bar and 288 Kelvin. So here it is given that the polytropic efficiency is 0.88 and assume that polytropic constant is n. So by using relation n minus 1 by n is equal to gamma minus 1 minus gamma divided by polytropic efficiency, we can find out n. So gamma is 1.4, so n comes out as 1.48. As overall pressure ratio is 4, so P0L by P01, P0L means stagnation pressure at the last stage and P01 means stagnation pressure at the inlet stage, is 4. It is. So using polytropic constant and relationship in polytropic process, P0L by P01 is equal to T0L by T01. Raise for n by n minus 1, you can find out T02 because T01 is known, that is 288 Kelvin. So T0L is 451.795 Kelvin. So that is the temperature at the exit of the compressor. Or you can say that overall temperature is T0L minus T01 or 451.795 minus 288, that is 163.795. And it is given that the temperature rise per stage should not exceed 25 degrees. So we take it as 25. Temperature rise per stage is 25. Then the number of stages are overall temperature rise divided by number of stages. So that is 6.5518. So taking the integer value, so number of stages, suppose we take 7. Okay, then the temperature rise per stage will be 23.4, which is less than 25. So it is feasible. So number of stages required are 7. Now the work done per stage is Cp delta Ts. Delta Ts is temperature rise in stage, so that is 23.4. So work done per stage is 1005 into 23.4, that is 23516 joule per kilogram. So this is equation number 1. So now last stage inlet and outlet velocity diagram are here. Okay, so this is absolute velocity, V1 is relative velocity, alpha 1 is entering angle of absolute velocity and beta 1 is your relative blade angle with the axial direction. Cw is bulk component, u is blade velocity. From the inlet velocity diagram, you can see that u is summation of this part and this part. So this part is v1, this part is ca1, tangent beta 1, this is beta 1, okay. And this part is CA1 tangent alpha 1. So U by CA1 is equal to tangent alpha 1 plus tangent beta 1. So this is equation number 2. U is blade velocity in the last stage. Okay. And CA1 is axial velocity. Okay. And C1 is absolute velocity entering the inlet stage. So that is given as 55 meters per second and alpha 1 is given as 28. So from this we can find out CA1 and put the value here and form an equation after putting the value of tangent 1. This is your fourth equation. This equation is your 3. Okay. So now we know that the work done from velocity to angle per kg is U change in wall component. So wall component is CW2 and CW1 at exit and inlet. So so it will be CW2 is CA tangent alpha 2 and CW1 is CA tangent alpha 1. Axial component remains same in axial compressor. So CA1 is equal to CA2, so we are taking as C. So CA is here 145.65, and tangent alpha 1 is here, this quantity. So in 50% reaction, and it is also given that degree of reaction, and it is also given that the diagrams are symmetrical. It is given that Bloch's diagram is symmetrical, so we can take 50% degree of reaction. So for this, alpha 2 is equal to beta 1. So we can put alpha 2 is equal to tangent alpha 2 is equal to beta 1 here. So now this is from velocity triangle, if we include a Bogdan factor also, that is 0.83, then the Bogdan per stage is this quantity. So now Bogdan per stage from the temperature relationship, we have found out that this is this. Okay, so equating these two, we can form another equation for you in terms of beta 1. First equation is from this, okay, so this is u in terms of beta 1. So by using these two relationships, we can equate u and find out beta 1. So beta 1 comes out as 60.44. And now if we put the value of beta 1 in either of the equation, we can find out u. So u comes out as 229.32 meter per second. Okay, so now from u, as mean diameter of the last stage is given as 180 m, so we can find out rotational speed by using pi dm by 60 is equal to 229 or u, that is 24331 rpm. And mass flow rate is given, that is 160 kg per minute or 2667 kg per second. So the stagnation pressure entering the last stage is 206 and leaving is here 207. And stagnation temperature is 306. Now, as temperature difference of these two, 307 and 306 is 23.4, so we can find out 306, so 306 comes out as 28.4. And from this temperature ratio, we can find out the pressure ratio of the last stage, that is 1.178. And then we can find out pressure, stagnation pressure also, because overall pressure ratio is 4, so final pressure will be 1.01 into 4, so P06 will be 3.4288 bar. So now velocity entering the last stage is 155 meters per second, and stagnation pressure is known, stagnation temperature is known, so from this we can find out static temperature. So static temperature is T0 is equal to T6, so the difference of static temperature will be equal to V square by 2Cp, so from this we can find out T6. Okay, so T6 is known now, and from T6 and from P06, using isentropic relation, we can find out stagnation, or sorry, static temperature. So static pressure, so that is T3.093 bar. From static pressure we can find out density at the entrance of the last stage. So from the density, using from density we can find out mass flow rate, that is density, that is area, that is axial velocity. So this area can be written as this d naught square minus di square can be written as d naught plus di. D naught by d naught plus di by 2 is your 180 mm mean diameter. Okay. So from this we can find out d naught by minus di, that comes out as 0.25 meters. So height or length of the last stage is d naught minus di by 2, that is 0.125 meters. And one more thing we have to find out, that is pressure ratio in first stage. So temperature at the inlet of the first stage is given as 288, and temperature at the exit of the first stage is 3114, adding 23.4. So pressure ratio in the inlet stage can be found out by using Holtrop equation. So now pressure ratio in the first stage is 1.27 from this, and we have calculated this last stage pressure ratio and speed and length. This is all.